I got a pop-up virus warning. Is my computer infected? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This turns out to be something very, very important to understand. Let's read the question first, then we'll get into some of the details. I recently started getting a new warning message when I visit some sites. It says that my computer has tracks of all the adult sites I've visited and that this will affect me in various ways. It recommends that I install a drive cleaning program to remove these tracks. Does this mean that my computer was infected by a virus, Trojan, or some kind of tracking software? Have I been hacked by someone? And do you recommend that I install the drive cleaning software? Is it safe? The short answer here is very, very simple. Do not install that software. It is very, very likely not to be safe. This turns out to be an entire class of ways that scammers and hackers try to fool you. The technical term is called scareware. They're trying to scare you into doing something that you really don't want to do. It manifests often in several different ways, and I want to show you at least one example of what that might look like. So here we are, running along in Windows, browsing askleo.com, and all of a sudden, we get this real scary message. In this case, this message that I'm showing you says something about Windows Defender giving you an alert that there's a virus been detected on the computer. Don't shut down. Don't reset. This is how it's scary. And then in this case, rather than suggesting you download a piece of software, they suggest that you call a specific number. That number is supposedly Microsoft Technical Department, which, by the way, doesn't exist. There's no department by that name. But if they were to get the department names correct, Microsoft Technical Support or Microsoft Support or any of that kind of stuff, this is fake. This is not real. Your computer is not infected, at least not by this. So the thing to notice, first of all, is that this particular message right now is in my browser. Now, I've faked this for demonstration purposes, but this is actually how these scams work. They bring something up in your browser that looks legitimate in many, many different ways. In this case, it's got the Windows logo. It talks about Windows Defender. In other cases, it looks like a pop-up message, a pop-up window, except it's not really a pop-up. It's all within your browser. And that's kind of the key here. If simply closing the browser or closing a browser tab, like I'm about to do here, if that makes the error go away, chances are very high that it was all fake. It was all a scam. It was all trying to get you to do something you don't want to do. Now, in my example message, it had you call a phone number. That leads to what we've come to call the tech support scam. They then will typically try and access your machine remotely to quote unquote fix whatever it is they claim. And in doing so, they'll probably install their own remote access software, their own malware, they'll hold your machine for hostage, any number of different things. The scenario that you described in your original question is also very common. They will call out a specific piece of malware that your machine is supposedly infected with and offer you a tool to download. I've seen them where they try and look like your ISP and have the ISP recommended download right there in the message. Click on this link to download updated antivirus. Don't do that. These are all attempts to get you to install something you really don't want on your machine. It's all fake. So what do you do? What do you do if you get one of these messages? Well, as I showed you, if you just close the browser tab, or close the browser entirely if you like, and the message suddenly goes away, it was never on your computer. It was on that website. That website may have gotten compromised, or something else along the way got compromised, or a browser toolbar got compromised. There are any number of ways that this can happen. They're all malicious, but they're all fake. So again, what do you do? What if you just aren't comfortable in assuming that it's been gotten rid of simply by closing a browser tab? Well, then the thing to do is to run a full scan using the anti-malware software you already have installed. Now, I'm going to do that. I'm running Windows Defender, my generally recommended version of security software to run. You can see here that, oh yeah, look at that. Windows Defender has a little bit of an alert. It has an action recommended. Now, in this case, in my case, it simply has a setting that I may want to turn on. Has nothing to do with what we're dealing with today. Virus and threat protection. I could do a quick scan. A quick scan basically targets the places on your machine where things are most likely to show up. But instead, what I'd rather do, I click on scan options, I'm going to do a full scan. And I'm going to scan now. And you can see that it has begun a full scan. If there's something on your machine, this is the scan you can trust. This is the one you can believe. Now, the other thing that I didn't do here, because I don't want to take the time to do it in this video, is I could also visit Windows Update real quick, hit check for updates, and make sure I've actually got all of the most recent updates for Windows Defender. But even if I don't, running a full scan with whatever software, whatever security software you already have installed, is absolutely the thing to do. By far, the most important thing you can do is to learn to recognize what a legitimate message looks like. It'll come from Windows, for example, probably down here in the popup message notification, rather than some random place on the screen. On the other hand, you may have third-party software installed. Know what that looks like. Know what to expect out of the software that you have installed. Know what you have installed. If you don't run, say, McAfee, and you get a pop-up message from McAfee, chances are somebody's trying to pull one over on you. That kind of thing is important to understand, important to realize, and important to not react to out of fear. The right thing to do is run a full scan if you want to, but arm yourself, protect yourself, be skeptical, follow all of the steps to keep your computer safe on the internet that I've got outlined in Internet Safety, 7 Steps to Keeping Your Computer Safe on the Internet. That's what you do. Don't download or call a number that's been presented to you by a pop-up that you didn't expect. Hope that's helpful. For comments, for updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/3107. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.